Welcome to American Airgunner. The guys now will be outdoors at the range to get a side-by-side comparison of a .22 long rifle with and without a silencer. We'll also be indoors sitting down at the round table to talk about air tanks and the best ways to store and travel with them. And finally, Steve Kreiner, the dog soldier, is with us. This week, he's in Wyoming with the all-new Umarex Gauntlet. These problematic rock chucks don't stand a chance. All this coming up right now on American Airgunner. All right, welcome to the round table at the range. We've got the godfather of air guns, Mr. Tom Gaylord, our resident hunter, Jim Chapman, and Tyler.
How are you doing, Tyler?
He needs a nickname.
No, I'm good.
Today we are talking what I call a lot of things. We're talking silencers. Silencers.
Real silencers.
Okay, so all you naysayers out there, just bite your tongue for a second. This is a common thing. You buy a gun and it has what looks like to the non-expert a silencer on the end, but they're not.
Well, sometimes they are, usually they're not. In the lower price guns, maybe not. Price of the guns go up, sometimes they put baffles inside and they do work like a silencer.
Inside of the industry, they talk about suppressors, but when they market them outside, they'll call the same thing a silencer.
Sure.
But the thing is, on air guns, sometimes what looks like a suppressor slash silencer isn't.
Or you get something like this, where it's just the entire barrel is baffled, and basically it's essentially a really, really long suppressor.
So
right?
We normally call that a shroud, yeah.
Okay, shrouded barrels. But these are all suppressors, silencers. It's all the same concept, am I right?
Yeah, it is. But the great thing about shrouds is that they're full length and they're usually built into the gun, so there was never that legality or the legal issue about, do you have a detachable silencer?
Right, and that's kind of the big thing we're talking about right now.
Well, legality is what we're talking about, right. Yeah. And when it's air guns, the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms has no jurisdiction.
Those guys know how to party.
But if you can take it off of an air gun and put it on a firearm, then you better have a permit
for
it.
That's right. If it comes off for even one shot, if you take a suppressor off of an air gun, mm-hmm. and it can last one shot on a firearm, it becomes a firearm suppressor. Right. And you need to have all the appropriate
and
licenses.
And Rossi, I'd like to show you what that entails, because that's the big deal here.
By all means.
Getting permission to have a silencer, a legal silencer, has gotten simpler, but only a little bit. When I got one, six, 7 years ago, I had to go to my local chief of police and apply, and if he didn't want me to have one, I was done. If he doesn't want you in his district, then you're not gonna get one.
Right.
If he allows you to, then he fingerprints you so that the FBI will have your fingerprints on file.
Okay.
You then apply to the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, Firearms, and Explosives. I forgot to add that before.
Sure, that's new.
And you send them $200, and they give you this stamp. When you get the paperwork back with approval, you may then legally go purchase your silencer. However, they have to know what serial number is on your silencer, because this is also considered a firearm. So before—
The silencer's considered a firearm.
Yep, right. For legal purposes, yes. So before I apply, I go down to a silencer seller. I said, I wanna buy a silencer. They said that'll be, I think it was $325. I sent them the money, they sent me the serial number, and they shipped the silencer to a Class 3 dealer. And he held it for over a year, because that's how long it took the paperwork to go through
now
the process.
Now that's down to about really? 6 to 8
yes,
months.
That's the
really?
Same guy you'd use to buy a machine gun through, though,
that's
right?
That's correct. Okay. Yeah.
All right, well, here's what we're going to do today. We have a .22 long rifle, and we're going to test it.
Before we do that, if I could.
You can.
To get the silencer on this Ruger 10-22, Dennis Quackenbush made this adapter. This adapter slips over the muzzle.
It's not easy to get a silencer.
It's a process.
Yeah, it's a process. It's not difficult. Like, I have a buddy who just did it. He didn't have to go through the local police department stuff.
You don't
anymore. State by state, it varies as well in terms of what you might need, or even in your county. It was relatively simple. You know, you file the paperwork, and the big thing is you have to establish a trust or some way to house the suppressor so other people can use it. That's the thing. It's registered to his name and his name only.
Wow.
So if he wants other people to be able to use it, he has to have a trust with other people's names, other trustees on it.
Right.
So it's very interesting.
Want to hear the difference between a silenced .22 and a non-silenced .22? Then keep watching. American Airgunner is brought to you by Umarex Airgun, zeroed in. By Pyramyd Air, the world's largest retailer of air guns, and by the Boot Campaign. Awareness, patriotism, assistance. Well, we're in the middle of Texas, outside of Austin, and it's pouring down rain, so we don't get to shoot air guns anymore outside. Thank God for airsoft! We call this hotel room trick shots with airsoft guns. Molly, we call this first one breaking the ice. Yeah! Let's get started. This is gonna be awesome. We call this the Ottoman bank shot. Yes! That was awesome! Airsoft lifesaver. Still raining. All right, we call this spinny chair. Spinny! Spinny. Did I go in? Oh, it did go in! I thought it was short. Spinny chair. Here comes the poop chute. Yeah! I got it? Yes! I knew I did my best work in the bathroom. I've always told my wife that. Still raining. I'm thirsty. Bartender, I need some ice. Yeah! That's exactly what I wanted, was some ice for my Coca-Cola. Hey, don't do this at home, kids. Just do it in a hotel.
All right, we're back at the range talking about silencers. Let's hear the difference these things can make.
Okay, I'm gonna load the gun.
I'm gonna sit back here, I think.
Okay.
And you're at 1228, so.
1211?
You hit a target.
All right.
In the gun.
I'm the godfather, but I let you, the host, put it on, because that's cool.
Wow.
Okay, now y'all heard how this sounded just a moment ago. Ready to go. Okay.
Seriously?
That's what we've been telling you.
That was just the sound of the gun. Right. It does not sound anything like the movies.
No.
Hollywood's been lying to us for years.
For years.
Who'da thunk?
I mean, that's crazy. Literally all I'm hearing is the action, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's make the correlation here to air guns. When you're looking at, you know, a suppressor like this on the end, the half shroud here, the full barrel shroud, what do you get the most effect from, and why should people care or look for these types of things in their air guns?
The full shroud is usually the best if
that's
it's well done. Usually. I have seen add-on silencers that were very good, but the full shroud has more.
It depends
room,
on the baffles and how they configure it. You know, that's really going to impact
it. Also
it.
Depends on the velocity of the gun, because if you're pushing out a lot of air, that silencer has a lot to deal with. Mm-hmm. But if you're running less air, there's not so much to deal with. Mm-hmm. That'll change the.
Well, you know, we talked about springers a minute ago. If you want to really quiet a springer down,
you get a PCP.
You don't use the hyperlight pellets.
Yeah.
The thing is, you use a standard pellet. Your velocities go down and the sound goes down. And that's one of those things of balancing when you use those type of pellets. What are you trying to accomplish?
So there you go, guys. That's it for this round table at the range. I think we proved a couple things that we wanted to prove. Hollywood lies to us, so they're not, silencers aren't as cool as you hope that would be. They're very difficult to get when it comes to firearms, but if you know you want one, that's your thing. But when it comes to air guns, know what you're getting. Just because it has the design or looks like that, that doesn't mean it's gonna do what you want it to do. So make sure you study the gun and get the kind of gun that you want for whatever reason you want it. And the most important thing I think we learned is that whether you call them silencers, suppressors, shrouds, shrouded barrels,
LDC and moderator.
You're all talking about the same stuff, so don't be so quick to type in there, it's called a suppressor! Because it's kind of called whatever you want it to be. Because they all do the same thing. For more information, go to AmericanAirGunner.com. Thanks for watching.